I'd like to begin today's program by thanking our 2022 annual sponsors. With their support, we're able to host events like today's event. Thank you all again for your contributions. We'd also like to sincerely thank the St. Bernard Parish Tourism and Film and the St. Bernard Parish Tourist Commission for partnering with us to make this such a wonderful event. Okay, now it's my pleasure to turn the program over to the Executive Director of Tourism and Film, Katie Tomasio.
On behalf of the St. Bernard Parish Tourist Commission and the St. Bernard Office of Tourism and Film, we would like to thank Lieutenant Governor Billy Nunngesser, St. Bernard Parish government employees and all the departments, the St. Bernard Parish Council, the administration, the elected officials, and community partners for always supporting and encouraging tourism and film here in historic St. Bernard Parish. Also, thank you to Elizabeth Dotrieve and the St. Bernard Chamber of Commerce for your continued support towards the tourism and film industries here in St. Bernard Parish. The past 2 years have been the hardest hit by the travel and entertainment industries that we've ever faced. Lengthy closures, record job loss, lack of connection, uncertainty, and anxiety. Both industries are setting their eyes on the future of travel and the future of film, a future that is driven by all of us in every corner of our country, in every sector of our industry. A brighter future starts now, starts today. The film industry in St. Bernard Parish creates job opportunities and increases local spending. The St. Bernard Office of Tourism and Film co-manages the film permitting process. And I would have to thank Ms. Donna Lopez and administration and the Sheriff's Department for assisting us in this process. Even though President McGinnis, the sheriff, always blames you for when we have road closures to the public. So just wanted to let you know that, even though he signs off on the permit first. The office also oversees the St. Bernard Film Incentive Program, which was created to encourage filming and economic growth by offering rebates for lodging, staffing, and other production spending in the local community. A six-person panel, the Film Incentive Review Board, includes two certified public accountants, Brian Polk with the St. Bernard Sheriff's Department, and David Huff with Huff & Associates, Megan McCormick with the Economic Development Foundation, Ms. Wanda Alcon, the council-appointed representative, myself, and film advisor Jason Wagensbach with the Ranch Studios. In 2020, the film industry delivered $813 million in state spending, $338 million in earnings for residents, and supported over 10,000 jobs. That spending would have not occurred without the film program incentives. In 2022, the St. Bernard Film Incentive Board approved a rebate of $150,000 to Danny Productions for the series Your Honor. That rebate was based upon a 3.5 spend of local qualifying expenses. That one production spent $4.6 million here directly in St. Bernard Parish. Since 2017, the Film Incentive Program issued $329,000 in qualified rebates. The rebates were based on expenditures totaling $9.853 million that was spent directly in St. Bernard. Of 35 public and community colleges in the state, 25 schools offer some form of digital media, film production, or film studies. In 2022, St. Bernard Parish had 18 TV series, movies filmed here in our community. Also, St. Bernard Parish government issued 43 film permits this year. The film industry is an economic driver for our parish, and I look forward to the future of film in 2023. And here are some of, is a video, thank you to the Ranch Studios, of some productions and series that have been filmed here in St. Bernard.
My son, I dedicated my whole life to him. And level of love can just crack you open.
Man who made is unreal. They did a phenomenal job creating the world around us. Best time on set.
This has been a dream. This has been so fun.
I think everyone brings a really lovely energy.
What is it, Ted?
Well, you know, we're dead and we're in hell.
Rumor is the Tremont is haunted.
Tell me there's a way out of this.
We would like you to transfer to another prison and befriend someone. Had the chance to stop him.
You are now 5,000 miles from land.
Thank you, Jason, and to Mr. Sidney Torres and everyone over at the Ranch Studios, and to all of our community partners that allow filming at your facility or your home. We truly appreciate the cooperation and the work that we do together into making St. Bernard a better place financially, for sure, with the film industry. Thank you. The St. Bernard Tourist Commission, whose members are appointed by the St. Bernard Parish Government Administration and Council members, supports the St. Bernard Parish Office of Tourism and Film in planning, personnel, advertising, promotional campaigns, which are implemented to increase tourist visitation and spending. The St. Bernard Tourist Commission administers the 2% hotel-motel tax, and the Office of Tourism administers the day-to-day operations of the tourism and film industries here in St. Bernard Parish. I would like to thank the UNO Hospitality Research Center and the Louisiana Department of Culture, Recreation, and Tourism and the Lieutenant Governor for providing the following tourism numbers that we receive every year. In 2021, St. Bernard Parish generated $85.3 million in visitor spending, which was a 68% increase over 2020, and a 25% increase over 2019. 1,115 jobs and over $30.8 million in employment earnings were generated by visitor spending in 2021. Visitors contributed to $8.4 million in state and local revenues for St. Bernard Parish, resulting in a 72% increase over 2020 and a 22% increase over 2019. In 2021, tourism generated $3.97 million directly to St. Bernard Parish when compared to 2020, generating $2.35 million to local taxes. There was also a 68.94% increase in tax revenues. There was an increase in hotel motel tax revenues of 73.96% in 2021 compared to 2020. If it were not for state and local taxes paid by tourists visiting St. Bernard Parish, each household would pay $554 on your taxes. Some of our accomplishments: we were awarded a $20,000 grant from the Department of Culture, Recreation, and Tourism. We received 3 Louisiana Seafood Board grants. We were awarded $79,000 of grant funding from the Tourism Revival Program, which more money will be coming down that pipeline. We successfully completed the annual cultural district report for state recertification. We renewed a cooperative endeavor agreement with the St. Bernard Port. We sponsored several local and statewide events. We hosted several tours, including the Louisiana Pageant Queens. And I'd like to thank our pageant queens for attending today, Miss Tomato, Miss Crawfish, and Miss Redfish. Thank you, ladies. And thank you for all you do in promoting St. Bernard Parish across the great state of Louisiana. Also, the American Queen, Leadership St. Bernard, and Mid-South Women in Tourism. We also celebrated National Travel and Tourism Week. We participated in the annual Lieutenant Governor's Tourism Summit, hosted the Republic of the Philippines government, dedicated the First Baptist Church of Verretville Cemetery marker, dedicated the Fazanville Historic marker, and supported the new WYES documentary presented by our proud presenting partner, the Arlene and Joseph Miro Foundation for Fazanville. Looking forward in 2023, our tourism team member, parish historian Bill Hyland, is leading the way in the application process for Verretville and Fazanville to be included on the African American Heritage Trail through the Louisiana Office of Tourism. We also awarded grant funding to 46 recipients, as you can see on the screen. We also placed ads in over 50 media outlets. And if anyone is ever interested in any kind of sponsorship or grant from the St. Bernard Tourist Commission, we meet the third Wednesday of every month. Just please contact me so we can put you on the agenda. And please do so in a timely manner so that it takes about a month to process those requests. At this time, I'd like to present the Friend of Tourism Award. The Friend of Tourism Award is an award that the St. Bernard Tourist Commission presents each year to an organization that supports tourism, that helps us, they volunteer, they help promote St. Bernard Parish. And this year, I am so honored to say that my dear friend and Louisiana's loyal leader, Mr. Billy Nunngesser, is the recipient of the Friend of Tourism Award. Yes, sir. Thank you, Bill. Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't go. You're going to be right up. So, yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And Billy, I have to. Santa also wanted me to present this T-shirt to you for our Santa on the Bayou annual event. So,
thank you so much.
I just wanted to give that to you. So thank you very much, sir.
Wow, that is special. Thank you. Thank you.
And at this time, I'd like to present Lieutenant Governor, Mr. Billy Nunngesser, my dear friend. Thank you.
Wow. I'm speechless now. Thank you all very much. That is quite an honor. From an incredible parish, and this place is not just special because y'all voted for me more than any other parish in the state, and that's why I can never tell Katie no. But you are a model for what other parishes should do. An incredible sheriff, parish president, council, working with the community, with families like Sidney Torres and the ranch, and businesses that all pitch in to help. And I saw that the first time I came over after Katrina to pull a vehicle out of a finance company that I had started here in St. Bernard and didn't think it would ever recover. And this community is a model for pitching in and helping your neighbor is all about. So it is a special place and doing incredible things. I will tell you not a joke, but a true story. It means everybody had a joke. I was got to speak at the National Republican meeting in New Orleans, and I drew the card to speak after Pence and before Trump. And it was quite an interesting crowd of big Republican supporters from all over the country. And of course, Pence was talking about moving forward, and Trump was still talking about stolen election. So when I got up to speak, I had 3 minutes, and I said, what am I going to tell these people? So I said, look, I'm a I'm the Lieutenant Governor of the great state of Louisiana. And I'm from a little parish south of here, a little finger that sticks out in the Gulf. And before I was Lieutenant Governor, I was parish president. That's a county where most of y'all are from. And we had a leader down there named Judge Perez. And when the governor of Louisiana needed a couple hundred votes to swing an election, he'd call the judge and say, "Judge, I need a couple hundred votes. Can you help me out?" And he would grab Dutchie, his bodyguard, and he'd head down to Burris to the graveyard. And as the judge walked down the aisle in the graveyard calling out names, Dutchie would be writing them down. And about halfway through the graveyard, Dutchie would say, "Judge, I think we got enough names here to swing the election." And the judge would say, "Oh, no, son, the people in the back of the graveyard have just as much right to vote as the people in the front." And that was no joke. But the people from all over the country got a real kick out of that, and they're still talking about it. So that's a true story. I want to tell you, before I talk about tourism, we have engaged another study. Back when we first had to renew the tax credits, there were some people debating whether it was worth it. And as I traveled the country and the world, and people would say, "I came to New Orleans because of NCIS New Orleans," or "I went to Natchitoches because of Steel Magnolia." People came to Louisiana because of TV shows and movies. So I knew it had some value. So we did a study that showed that 9% of everyone that visits Louisiana is heavily influenced by a TV show or movie. That's over $1.5 billion of economic benefit to the tourism industry. So we are up in that study, updating it right now. It'll be finished in January. So we know this is the last year of the five-year commitment to renew that tax credit. And we want it, but election year, anything's possible. So we want to make sure that all the legislators understand the real value. So we'll be having that study in January. We will get it to the legislators to make sure that we don't mess this up and renew that tax credit for another 5 years. So I thank you all for what you do and your support of that. You know, prior to COVID, we had our fifth record-breaking year. Over 53 million people visited little old Louisiana, left behind $1.9 billion in taxes that you and I didn't have to pay. That's a little over $1,100 per Louisiana family. Now, we knew coming out of COVID, we had to think outside the box, do things a little different from other states. We're competing against every state for those tax, those visitors. And so we had to say, what better way to do it than with a parade? So we went and solicited to get in the Macy's parade. And they gave us a float, and I said, "We're not putting a name on that. We build floats." We went back and forth for 2 months. And finally, they gave us the longest float ever, that super gator crawling down the streets of New York, and we stole the show. And you know, some naysayers said, "You invested $1.3 million, that's a lot of money for a 3-year commitment." But I'll tell you, the first year, we got our money back 50 times over. Over $15 million in press, and people went to our website and booked trips to Mardi Gras all over Louisiana. You see, we promote Mardi Gras in every corner of the state. Family-friendly, affordable, safe Mardi Gras. And as a matter of fact, last year, out-of-state visitors for Mardi Gras was up in every community in the state except New Orleans. So we're going to continue to do that. I don't know if you ever get a chance to go out to this parade. They don't throw anything, so people just stand there and wave. I don't get it. But the week leading up to the parade, we were in Times Square, and all at once, all those cameras went dark. And then this alligator eye appeared, and the whole crowd would stop and look up. And then it would kind of zoom out and tell you, "Get ready, New York, Louisiana's coming. Take a look." So it really stole the show in New York. The first year, we knocked it out the park, and this year again. It worked so well, we went out to the Rose Parade, and we asked if we could get a float. And when I walked in, the lady said, I asked her, she had a pin on it, said, dream, believe, achieve. I said, ma'am, what does your pin mean? She said, well, that's our theme this year. She said, Mr. Nunngesser, will you be riding with us? And I had to think quick. I hadn't thought about it. I said, no, ma'am. I said, we're going to put a teacher of the year, a police officer of the year, a doctor, a nurse that risked their life during COVID to keep us safe, Miss Louisiana, the Cajun Navy. You see, ma'am, everybody's been hit with COVID, but we went through two of the worst hurricanes ever to hit the United States. We could really use a little shot in the arm, no pun intended. We could use this lift up for Louisiana. And she said, I have one other question. Does everyone in Louisiana have that much passion? I said, yes, ma'am, we all do. But I'll tell you, once again, we stole the show. We got best entertainment and best floral design. And if you want to make a trip of a lifetime, we invite all of Louisiana to come out. It's done with all volunteers. We put 34,000 roses on that float last year in 3 days. This is the float being built this year so far. So that's what it'll look like when it's finished. Now, when I got out there last year and saw that steel float, and they said it'll be ready in 3 days, I went nuts. I'm saying, no way we're going to get this thing done in 3 days, but they do with a lot of volunteers. So if you want to go out there, trip of a lifetime. And I'll tell you, once again, we picked an incredible superstar. When we presented Lainey Wilson, she was a little-known singer from Lafayette, and just recently, she won at the CMA Awards, Best New Artist, Best Female Vocalist of the Year. So she'll be out there on the float performing, and there will be a special night there. I believe it's Wednesday night that all Louisianans that come out to decorate that float, she will perform at a special party for Louisiana. Now, you know, here's a video from her, how excited she is to ride.
Hey y'all, it's Lainey Wilson. I cannot tell you how thrilled I am to have been selected to be a tourism ambassador for my home state of Louisiana. I love everything about Louisiana. The crawfish, the birthplace of jazz, Zydeco, agriculture, fishing, the drive-through daiquiri shops, the Creole and Cajun culture, Mardi Gras bayous, you name it, Louisiana has got it. Everywhere I go, I invite visitors to come and experience all that Louisiana has to offer. There is no better place to feed your soul. I'm also so excited to share that I'll be performing on the Louisiana Float in the 2023 Rose Parade on January 2nd. I cannot wait to showcase Louisiana on a worldwide stage. There's no party like a Louisiana party, so meet me in Pasadena or watch it live at home. Celebrate the new year with me and Louisiana.
So, I know y'all have seen this next video before, but I never get tired of watching it. And we just won another international award for the best video coming out of COVID promoting our state. You know, we took You Are My Sunshine, the second most recognized song in the world, and we bought the rights and got Lauren Daigle to re-record it to the great outdoors of Louisiana. And it continues to be a hit to draw people to Louisiana. So I'm going to close with that.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine.
You come to Louisiana for smiles, not souvenirs. You come here to get lifted up, spun around, and put down in a brighter, lighter place.
You make me happy when skies are gray.
You come here for the distinctive music and the amazing food. But what really spills out of the horns and over the edges of your plate is joy. Some people might call it joie de vie, the joy of life. In Louisiana, it's our way of life.
You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. So please don't take my sunshine away.
So come live life to the fullest, where there's an abundance of good food, good music, and good times. So there's more than enough to go around. Come one, come y'all. This is Lauren Daigle inviting you to come feed your soul in Louisiana.
You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. So please don't take my sunshine. Please don't take my peace. Don't take my sunshine away.
Thank y'all very much. This means the world to me. I love you, St. Bernard.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor. Thank you. And at this time, I'd also like to thank the Tourist Commission members, our chair, Ms. Phyllis Dysadu, our vice chair, Jessica Reeb, our secretary, Ms. Jennifer Heinz, our treasurer, Ms. Lena Nunez, board member, Ms. Dorothy Hills, Claire Henderson, and Mr. Gary Hittman. Thank you all for what you do. Thank you. At this time, on behalf of the St. Bernard Parish Tourist Commission, we would like to present a check to Nunez Community College in the support of Voyage Mark, an outdoor walking exhibit, a full-scale model of our solar system. Nunez Community College offers the only aerospace program in the great state of Louisiana. Students and visitors are a critical part of the Nunez chapter of NASA Artemis. This innovative exhibition will assist in thriving tourism in St. Bernard Parish. And Dr. Tenney could not be here with us today, so Ms. Catherine Lemoyne, who's with Nunez Community College and a school board, a St. Bernard Parish school board member, I'd like to give you this check. And thank you to the Miro Foundation also to contributing to this new exhibition. This will be great. Lieutenant Governor, you got to check this out. We need one that says Louisiana, feed your soul. I would also like to thank our tourism team members, Mr. Bill Hyland, Samantha Meyer, and Faith Moran, for all the hard work and dedication that you do. I know at times I'm not always easy and kind of spoiled, so thank you all for taking care of me. I would also like to thank Maureen, Mary, and Tony for assisting us with this event today. I think the facility looks great. And I'd also like to thank Rachel and Leo for helping us with the videos here today. We have one more video to show before I turn it back over to the Chamber of Commerce. Thank you.
Dreaming of this since a child. I'm on top of the world, eh? I'm on top of the world, eh? Been waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting to smile, eh? Been holding it in for a while, eh? Take you with me if I can. Been dreaming of this since a child.
You guys, but that video just makes me love where we live so much. Thank you, Rachel, for putting that together. It's a great reminder of all the wonderful things we have here in St. Bernard. I do want to thank all of you for being here today. Speaker of the House, Clay Snechsteiner, thank you for being with us this afternoon. And as Katie said earlier, I do want to thank everyone that helped make today such a huge success. Mo, you and your team always outdo yourself with this facility. It is gorgeous. Thank you, guys. And thank you to the Tourist Commission and the Office of Tourism for all your hard work today to make today a success. And with that, we are ending out the year here at the Chamber. I thank you all for participating in all our events. We do have a few more. Check out our Facebook for all our events for the rest of the year. But we look forward to seeing you guys again in 2023. Still hard to say New Year's, y'all. I'll get there probably halfway through next year. But anyway, if you are on our chamber board, the Tourist Commission and the Office of Tourism are an elected official, if you could meet us in the back for a photo. And thank you again for joining us. And congratulations again, Lieutenant Governor, on being a friend of tourism.